it's Uncle Demi. Everybody gather around the campfire. I got another one, man. I got another one. Listen, I actually like this one, man. I like all the builds, but I like this one a lot, man. This right here is definitely a really good build. Extremely playable on all different levels. And I'm just going to hop right into it. Now, listen. You want to use this pie chart here, right? And then here, you can kind of choose what you want to do. You're a mid-range specialist. But for me, I felt like just being a well-balanced player would be the best. So that's what I went with. All right, so here, you want to get your shooting close. You want it to be, gotta be low. 69, all right? Here is 65. Here is going to be 60. Your standing dunk's going to be maxed out, all right? You max out your mid-range. 76 here for your three. You max out your free throws and your post fade, all right? When it comes to your dribbling, you want this to be 73. And this right here is going to be maxed out to 74 ball handling. And then you want to max out your post. So you can already tell, man, like this mid-range specialist is going to be really, really, really good, bro, down low, man. All right. The post moves, the post fade. And like I said, getting to the rack is going to be something that's going to be not necessarily like his game, right? His game is going to be in the mid-range area, obviously. All right. From a defensive standpoint, you want to max out your interior defense. You want to max out your perimeter, your lateral quickness, and your steals. And then you want to use the rest on your defensive rebounding, right? So just looking at this, you have one finishing badge. You have 21 shooting badges. You have 15 playmaking badges. And you have two rebounding badges. This build is solid. Like, there's no way ifs, ands, or buts about it. Like, you're going to be able to dribble, and you're going to be destroyed. Like, let's imagine being a guard on a twos court, and you have a center, maybe a sharp shooting rim or something like that, and you have little guards that you just post up and destroy. Like, literally, just sit there and post them up. This is like a mid-range specialist can also be like a shot-creating post scorer. Like, this is basically what it is. I think this is a really, really, really good build and a very fun build. I just know this can be a fun build, and I like this build so much that I'm actually going to make this build and play with it a little bit, because you can do a little bit of everything. Like, literally, you can do a little bit of everything. And even though your driving dunks is 60 and 65, 69, but guess what? You're still going to be able to dunk, and you're still going to be able to, you know, if you get the ball in the rim, do a standing dunk. I think this is a great build, all right? Body type, no, don't really matter, man. Define, right? 6'7 is the height. From the weight standpoint, just keep it at 218. You can't really change anything as usual. Here, this is dope. You can get a post scoring takeover as a small forward. Cook down low, or you can go to shot creating. Me, I decided to go shot creating, but post scoring is something I really, really strongly considered. And I think that if you really want to have fun and just be like, you know, have a fun build and trying something different, get post scoring takeover. That'll really throw people off. Mid-range specialist with post scoring? Oh my God. Right? So, here's the build. Mid-range specialist, all right? I think Kawhi Leonard and Paul George and Paul Pierce definitely dominate in the mid-range. I think that there's other builds that will more suit them, but I honestly, for the first time, I can say I'm not necessarily looking at this like, damn, like that has nothing to do with any of these guys. It's actually pretty solid, so I'll go with that. All right, now let's test the build out. All right, here we go. That kind of took a long time, right? All right, so let's just get this 99. Let's go ahead and here, let's just go, I don't know, contact finisher, right? All right, from the shooting standpoint, I think this right here is gonna be quick draw course. You wanna go difficult shots, deep post fades. You want to go catch and shoot, dead eye, and then I think that hot zone hunter and green and not hot start, green machine. All right, I think these will be the best from what I've been thinking about doing, because I really think that you're gonna do a lot of fadeaways, right? A lot of difficult shots and fadeaways. I think these two will go together. Dead eye is just because I think that you will be shooting close. If you don't feel like you are going to be doing a lot of standing shooting, you can take that, maybe put that on catch and shoot on silver, and then maybe go with green machine or hot zone hunter. I'm really big on hot zone hunter, right? So keep in mind, like I said, you're gonna be doing a lot of back to the basket stuff, like Carmelo Anthony does. You know what I mean? Like, this is a perfect Carmelo Anthony build, right? From the playmaking, again, where you at? Quick first step. All right, Hall of Fame. Everybody knows, like, that is just something Melo did. Dimer, don't do that. You're definitely not passing the ball. Let me stop. All right, post-game technician. Come on, man. A small forward Hall of Fame postman? Like, come on, man. This build is fun. This is a fun build, man. This is something that I really think is going to be great. So you can go Dream Shake, right? Being able to do post fakes, but I don't think that. So anyway, I don't want to do that. I want to go here with Hall of Fame Space Creator. And then where is my other one at? Where you at? Downhill. All right. Increasing the ball down transition. Now, if you say, for instance, you want to do this as basically as a twos build, whatever, then you take that off, and then you can either go with where you at? Where's it stopping? That stop and go. Trying to find it. Where you at? Break starter. Ankle breaker. All right. So, and the reason why I say ankle breaker is because for this build here, if you're gonna be doing a lot of ISO, your quick first step could be great, but you're gonna be able to do hop steps, right? And hop steps, along with Space Creator and Ankle Breaker, is gonna help you out a lot. So just keep that in mind. You know, being a shot creator with Shot Creating Takeover, doing hop steps with Ankle Breaker is gonna really work with you. Okay. So I think that would be perfect. And then on a defensive side, I think that this right here is basically just go with clamps, silver clamps. All right. And then you have it. You know, you have a really, really fun build that I really, really am going to enjoy. You have 6 Hall of Fame badges. You have 2 gold badges. You have 4 silver, and you have 1 bronze. Comment down in the section. Tell me this is not going to be a fun build. This is basically a post-going shot creator, which one of those builds in 19 that a lot of people was making because it was so fun to have that dual takeover. So like, just think about it. Just get post-going takeover with as a small forward, and just like think about how you would destroy these little point guards. Like, it's unbelievably a fun build, man. I think this is a great, great fun build to play with on the twos court. And if you get lucky, hell, you might be able to take this on a 1v1, because you do have that post ability, and you do have, you know, clamps to where you can be able to play 1v1 against smaller guards, and also be able to size up with some centers. And just, you know how, like, right now with posting, it's not necessarily the most secure when it comes to securing the ball. Like, right now there's a lot of glitches where, like, people can spam square and take it away. Also, like I said, this is good for a rec, because you can shoot the 3, you can play like a point forward. Like, it's a very versatile build, man. Spam up in the section what you think about this build. And also, like I said, if you watch the video all the way through, please, please, please leave a like emoji. Please subscribe. And you know, like I've been saying, I stream on Twitch every day. So if you want to see me play, I'm a competitive gamer, obviously. I mean, I'm part of the Flow Clan. You know, we play competitively. We do we play anywhere, play anybody. So like, if you just want to see me play and hear my commentary, and like, you know, just want to join in the stream and just say, hey man, you know, I saw, you know, I've been watching videos, whatever, that would be greatly appreciated. But of course, you know, hit the like button for this video, and by all means, please subscribe. Like I said, subscriptions give me energy to make me want to wake up every day and continue doing these builds. Other than that, man, I greatly appreciate it. And of course, I will see you the next time.